That's racist. Why do we need to watch the next video?
It could be one of those Afrocentric telling us about, you know, our ancestors type shit. But who was offended by that? Just by show of hands.
I ain't gonna lie.
Why?
Because like it was like a black kid, I feel like whenever they wanna portray like poverty or something, they always wanna point to like, you know, like a skinny little black boy or like, you know, some kid in Africa. You know, there's kids in Africa starving, like there's kids in Africa, like there's kids everywhere starving, why they gotta be black? So I feel like they could have showed like a more diverse setting of children versus just one little black boy that's, you know, skinny little phenomenon.
I mean, I don't take offense to it because the whatever their foundation is may sponsor like black kids. So if that's their target to feed the kids in Africa or whatever the child care, whatever that association does, then they're gonna promote that. They're not gonna show a white starving kid because they're not trying to help white starving kids.
I didn't take offense to it, however, I would critique it, and like she said, I would definitely have a better representation of the population, because it's not just black kids are starving, you know, there's white kids out here starving, there's Mexican kids out here starving. Starving is not just a black people thing.
I didn't like how she was feeding him like a doggy treat. Like every time he got on his knees to do something or handed her something in bed, or something like that, you know, I feel like you said, it could have been, he could have been doing something else to be rewarded the money, or why did, if it's a sponsorship, why is he even being rewarded, you know, like.
But the play on words was the fact that he was treated like a dog, like dogs are getting eaten better, so he's doing what the dog would do to get a treat.
Yeah.
I didn't catch on it.
Yeah.
I have a problem with that too, like, why, I don't get why they had to, I mean, I get what they were saying, but why compare a child to a dog? Not him being black, but a child at all, why compare him to a dog?
Because it was making like the statement, like this, that's the shopping statement. Yeah. Like, dogs are even better than kids.
Yeah, but that's why they use it.
Right.
I think the idea behind the media is that, you know, they take it from like statistic saying that more black people are impoverished. So that's why black people are there. And then it kind of gives us something that we know we used to, but we don't like to see it.
Yeah. That's just a bad marketing strategy altogether. Like, that's why I guess I never saw it on TV. You know, like a better way to present that whole cause, but that was just like a bad marketing strategy.
For it to be a white woman, black child, maybe they could have shown multiple other children.
Yeah. Now, yeah. Black woman feeding a black child, okay, because well, we don't donate to our own cause anyway, but I mean, it would have read better.
So what about like a black woman feeding a white child?
You would never see it. Never see it.
But that's not racist?
That's racist too.
I think it's because that's more of a stereotype.
Alright, so what if you wouldn't have seen the race of the kid? Like, then what?
It wouldn't really matter because then you're under an umbrella of just the population of hungry kids.
Yeah.
But I think because we are so used to the stereotype, especially in our day and age where we're dealing with so much racism between police officers and all the other kind of stuff, that's why it makes it more offensive.
That's interesting. But the commercial was from an organization called Feed a Child, and I think they made that commercial like 2008, but they never got to air it because of so much backlash. You know, but their point behind it was, you know, towards the end, that most domestic dogs eat better than some kids. But they were that was like an artistic interpretation of that fact. Like they meant to shock you. Mm-hmm. But according to them, they didn't see a white woman and a black child. They just saw a woman and a child. But, you know, to a black person, you might be like, oh, it's the white man keeping us down. Or to a white person, it might be like, oh, you know, nigger, they're better than dog, whatever the case may be. But the problem with this whole situation, the reason, you know, I thought it'd be a good topic is because if something like that seems racist, it's automatically racist. Like, whether or not that woman is Mother Teresa or the organization is actually helping people, just because they insinuated that a kid is just as good as a dog, and the kid happens to be black, racist.
So if the kid, if the lady is black and the kid is white, is that racist also? Do we think that's racist?
Yeah, I do. I feel like not so much, like, some people might be offended by it, but I feel like not as many people would be offended by it because, like, I think you have said because it's a stereotype that, you know, black kids are poor versus there's not really, that stigma is not really held against white kids that they're poor, you know. So I feel like it probably might shock some people or, you know, offend some people, but not most people.
So is it racist because it offends the most, the biggest amount of people?
That's what,
or because it's racist?
Because of the stereotype.
So it's not racist because it's racist, it's racist because
it was racist because of whatever the person who created the film intention was.
That's the hardest
but
thing.
But we don't know.
You can't tell somebody's intention.
Yeah.
It's some people who act like mean to black people, they're just mean people.
Yeah.
And they'll act just as mean to a white person. But that person, that old white man is racist. You know?
I wouldn't consider him racist.
No, no, I'm not saying,
yeah,
saying
the way it looks.
Exactly. Like, that's the first thing we jump to. Y'all heard about the girl at USC who gave her suspended.
Yeah.
You didn't hear about it?
Right.
She said the problem with the problem with Wi-Fi is niggers
parking. Incompetent professors.
With Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
First of all,
it's small parking.
Hold up,
I got the picture.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and, you know, because she wrote niggers, first of all, she's been suspended. She's about to be expelled.
White girl.
White girl. And she's pretty much waiting expulsion. NAACP is involved and all that kind of shit. So I thought to myself, first of all, I wasn't offended. The way I looked at it, and you guys might disagree, the way I looked at it, I would have been more offended if she said black people. Because I feel like when you say nigger, you're talking about a specific type of person.
I don't classify myself. So I'm like, yeah. Hey, what about the
when we know that her classification of the word nigger was not to just ignorant people.
Yeah.
It was we know that that's not the whole ignorant person who's used by her
right.
She meant white people who are.
Oh yeah.
Like I said, it's what the person's intention was. Her intention was to say black people are using up her Wi-Fi improperly or whatever the. Why she wrote nigger on a board, which is retarded.
Right. And you would think that they would realize you can't do this in this day and age. Like, we just had this go on in Oklahoma. We just had things like this pop up. And it's so, they're like, I say they, but these people that are continually messing up, no matter who the race, are just being ignorant to the fact that you will get in trouble for this. This is not okay. And it's like they're careless. They don't care anymore. And that's actually what's more offensive to me. They don't even care anymore.
Yeah.
It's like they're going backwards.
Right.
There was an era where they were scared of the black person.
Exactly.
Scared of NAACP because of, or even if we talk about like gay rights and all of that, you had to be, there was an era where we were very sensitive not to step on toes. That's no more. You are allowed to freely have your opinion about anybody and voice it and not expect any type of human rights.
I feel like that also might be because like it's been like underground for so long. Mm-hmm. Like it might be publicly eradicated, but because it's been manifesting underground for so long, it's starting to surface. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's starting to become something like, oh, that's a shocker, but we all know it's still there. It's just not there publicly, but it's still there, and now it's starting to become a public.
And what's bringing it out is social media.
Yeah.
Social media has exposed a lot of different people who we would have never known.
I've
never known these things. Things like Yik Yak and Twitter, like it's exposing so much that we thought was gone.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just bringing it back up. It never left.
I find that interesting because y'all said it's like we're going back, like they're not afraid of the black man anymore. I watched a video on Facebook of this white man. He was saying that the reason that there is so much racism is because they are still scared of the black man. They're scared, they're still scared of the revolt that's going to happen because they know that they put black people down for so long, or any minority really. They put them down for so long and act like they were so beneath them that they're trying to overcompensate now. Like now it's more of overcompensation rather than, it's not necessarily them no longer being afraid, but it's them overcompensating. So he specifically told white people, he said, you need to get over yourself. It was a white man talking to white people, he said, you need to get over it. You don't have superiority over anybody. You don't have rights to anything just because you're white. And I found it really interesting because I feel like he was saying a lot of things that minorities speak. But if we say it, it's more quick and wrong.
Yeah.
Kind of building off of what she just said, I also think it's a matter, I think that we can't, not necessarily we in this room, but as a race, can't get that mad when, because I'm personally more offended, ironically, by the word nigger than nigga, because I feel like we go around saying, nigga stop, you know, or nigga please, or whatever. And I feel like you make them comfortable. Like me, you know, I went to high school in Ohio, and I went to a primarily white honor school, and it's like the black people in my school, they didn't care pretty much. It was basically just a lot of people there that just didn't care. And they made the white people feel comfortable enough. Like a lot of white people have said nigga to my face, like to my face. And it was up to me to not be the stereotype to lash out, but to like kind of educate them or let them know like it was unacceptable. And even coming down south, I think it's more touchy than it is up north. But I think we make them feel more comfortable. And we kind of make it okay for that kind of stuff, some of us. I don't think we standard or one ground. I think we say that we're offended by it, but then we'll be like, oh yeah, this is my nigga Kelly. And she's like, you know, type of thing.
That's the problem, man, like, because, you know, to my view, like, more African Americans are racist. You know, they're racist to their own kind and to, like, more other people. Because, like, if you saw, like, a Saudi Arabian walking, automatically your thought is, like, 9/11. You know what I mean? Like, you, because of, like, that scare or whatever, or what happened with 9/11, but y'all know that y'all not trying to be racist, but that's just what happens.
I mean, that's prejudice. The calling of the N-word, like nigga, 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 like when Kentucky lost to Wisconsin, and he called the big white
Frank.
Guy,
oh,
they
yeah.
called Frank a nigga, but if Frank would have said it, it would have been taken
right.
way out of context, but that's, but it's like, either it's racist or it's not,
right.
So it's not, we're going to have to just kill the double standard, like I can say nigga, but a white person can't, like, if your homegirl calls you a bitch, oh, she, it's cool, but if a guy calls you a bitch, no matter what color he is, oh, well, I'm ready to fight him. So, it's a double standard.
It's funny, because me and Uncle, we were talking about this, and he was saying the same thing that you were saying, and I was saying, I've never been cool enough with a person of a different race. I've never been cool enough with them, so they can come up to me and be like, hey, yo, what's up, my nigga? Though I do say nigga. But I make a conscious effort to try not to say nigga when I'm in mixed company, because I do get offended if somebody else were to say it to me. So because I'm so used to saying the word nigga, it still comes out of my mouth. But I at least try not to say it in mixed company so nobody else will get the, yeah, they won't get comfortable.
We go back to the intention. I don't feel any white person that I've met is just that cool that they're just like, oh yeah, nigga's my word, you know, I just call him my nigga because he's my nigga. I feel if he's like, yo, what's up, my nigga, it's like, poke, poke, hey, did that get you? Hey, was that funny? No, I'm like that, and I'm never going to be at a comfortable standard for them to say that, because I know there's some type of little backlash behind it.
Yeah, because
they're saying that for a reason.
Yeah, because I feel like once they become comfortable, it's like if anything happens that can make them mad, that word will come out.
Yeah, what if they say
it
negative? Like we
way.
Say it negative.
Yeah.
Okay, what if that nigga out? What if he said that way? When it was cool, it was comfortable when he said, oh, yo, what's up, my nigga? But when he come back and y'all are beefing, that next thing, he's like, yo, I'm not this nigga out.
But I don't think.
Would it not be negative that time? Like, oh, he called me a nigga. Not even the fact that he said he's gonna knock you out. Like, he called me a nigga now.
But like she said, like, nigga and nigger. Like, I don't think nigga means, hey, you black, whatever, whatever. Like, I've heard white people call me, like, nigga, what are you doing? Like, you know what I'm saying? So, it's not that, hey, I'm calling this black person. So, what about white people calling each other niggas?
What is that?
I hate it. I
see their intent for it. Like, they're not. Their intent is not to be rude when they say like, what's up. Yeah, I understand. I'm not gonna. I don't like it, but I understand that they're not trying to be angry at it. Now, when they throw that ER on there,
that's
you can
yeah.
tell that
that's,
is
yeah.
anger and hate.
Yeah.
When they do "What's up, my nigga?" that's 9 times out of 10, they're doing that because they want to be cool with you.
Exactly.
But I'm gonna tell them that's not
right.
How
they right.
But you can say the same thing about the word bitch.
Right.
But it's spelled the same.
It's
way.
One of those words. Yeah. It's, like I said, it's one of those words that has like a. It's like a double meaning. It's a double edged sword. It's okay when some person says it.
Yeah.
But it's not like.
It's your own saying.
Personally, I believe you are what you answer to. If somebody right. called me a nigga and I don't think I'm a nigga, why would I be offended?
I mean,
me being offended says more about me.
But like I said, it comes with the connotation.
You can't tell anybody's connotation.
Yes, you can.
You can assume.
No,
you
can
assume. No, you can tell about what they say.
The white man says, you nigga, stay in your fucking place.
They could be trying to poke fun at you, sure. Or they could just... You'd be using it as a term of endearment.
But
like
even as a term of endearment, I would still let them know we're cool, but I don't want you to feel comfortable enough to say that around me.
So
because
you
when you come in contact with another black
you
person,
yourself
I don't want you to be able to say that.
Yeah. No. Okay, so if I called you gay, are you gay?
No.
Alright, so would that like offend you? If I called you gay?
I mean, like you said,
you can say whatever you want about me, and I tell that to anybody. They can say whatever they want about me. If it's not true, you can say it if you want to, anytime you want to.
Right.
If people say, hey, you don't think you're your kid, keep saying it. Because I think,
right.
I know I think they're my kid.
Right. Right.
You want to call me gay? I know I'm not. Keep going.
Right.
So that's just me personally. Like you said, if I don't classify myself,
we give the word too
don't.
Much power.
Yeah, that's it.
Because the fact that we can throw it around each other and it just be some white shit, but as soon as a white person says it, it's a right hook. You know what I'm saying? That's giving them power over us, not the reverse. People think it's cool that white people are scared to say nigga. That does more for them than us.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, think about it. The fact that somebody through one simple word can change your whole mood, your whole day, your whole freaking, your attitude, that's power. Not for you, but for them.
That goes with any words, though.
That goes with any words. Exactly. But the word nigga, go ahead, Zay. You've been raising your hand.
I just raised it.
Go ahead.
My thing is, if that's the case, then why people who came before us, why do they take, you know, the word nigga seriously? And of course, the same people that's been, you think they would have the same mindset as, like, as you have right now about giving the word too much power? Then why they feel that way then?
Well, I feel like the people that came before us, like we as black people, we can say, well, I don't like them saying nigga because they don't know what my people struggled through. Well, we didn't struggle through it. So really, we can't say, well, I struggled because we didn't. We didn't pick no cotton. I don't think nobody in this room picked no cotton. It was nobody's house laid. So I feel like they witnessed it and they were there and it was used to put them down on the day.
And that
basis.
It brings back like those same feelings.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's why they take so much offense to it. That's not even like giving power. That goes back to those people yelling at them, hosing them down, sick dogs on them. That word was being sprouted at them while that happened.
Okay.
So that's where the anger comes from, right?
But you think they went through all that so that same word can still be used to oppress us?
No, wait.
The word
to use it. Like we shouldn't be using it either.
My thing is, if you get offended when a white person says nigga, you should get offended when a black person says.
But in defense of the word, play devil's advocate. There's a document where one of the greatest African Americans of all time, Martin Luther King, referred to his friends as his nigga. So.
He still didn't want no white man.
Right. So I'm saying,
we didn't create that nigga word as slang. We didn't start that. The 90s didn't start that. The 80s didn't start that. They
That's
had to do it in the 40s and the 50s. These are my niggas.
Mm-hmm. That's been there.
Like we aren't the ones who made it cool or hip word. It's always been there.
Right.
Their language, our language. And we still, even in the 40s, the 30s, the 20s, when we still get hoes and had to enter in on the back on the brick roads and couldn't drink out the same water fountains,
mm-hmm.
they didn't like a white person saying that. I don't like a white person saying that. And I can't. There's nothing that can make me comfortable with that.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Why do you not like that word?
Why do I not like the word? Yeah. Because I honestly feel a person's intentions of saying that, a Caucasian's person's intentions. I got an Indian friend. And this might sound as ignorant as it could be in the world. He's Indian. I mean, he was born here and everything. But he could say the word nigga and that would not faze me at all.
I don't like that word. I don't like the word because of the history behind it.
Yeah.
And I feel like it also depends on like how you use it, because like the definition of it is ignorant. So
that means black ignorant.
I know, but I mean, I think if a Caucasian person uses around a black person, I do not, just in my personal opinion, and I'm from Boston. I'm from the whitest like area in the world. And maybe that's why I feel like that, because I know it's not them saying it because they're cool enough and been around that many black people. It ain't that many of us up there. If one of them said it, I know for a fact there's some type of, yo, I call him my nigger at the end of it. Like, I feel like they're getting off on it. Like, they get a little,
you know. But like, since you never know how good they feel about it, like.
I think it's because his experience with white people, with saying the word, has never been because he was cool with them. It's always been in a bad experience, which mine has too. My experience, if a white person has ever called me a nigger, it wasn't like, oh, she my nigger. It's been, she's a nigger, I don't like her, da da da. That's why I take offense when
y'all
white person says,
like,
because that's
the
connotation.
So did somebody, did a white person call you a nigger and it meant that you didn't?
I've been called a nigger, yes.
Yeah.
I've been called a nigger in high school, middle school, like, I've been called a nigger.
Like, y'all say South Carolina is in the South in general, the Bible Belt is like the suppressed states where the blacks still stick to the blacks and whites still stick to the blacks. Go to Boston, go to those whiter areas, the predominantly white areas. There's no mixture. I don't have a good, like, experience with Caucasians, you know, at all. So for me personally, and your perception is your reality. My perception of a white person calling me a nigga has never been in just genuine, what you call it, power of endearment. Like,
what if it's just the whole Southern hospitality shit? So their intentions might be the same, but just the way they show it. In Boston, they might be more showy, but a white person here will help you out and be part of the KKK, or be a police officer.
I'm talking about people. These people do not, moolies, that's what we are. They do not cross that line. There is no just, hey, we're all cool, and it's almost still like segregated schools and everything. Like, there's the Irish, there's the white, there's the Puerto Ricans and the blacks, and the Dominicans all over here in the pocket. We live in Southie, they live in Dorchester, Rochester. Like, it's not as mixed here. You can have rich white, broke black. You know what I mean? Like, either way, it doesn't matter. There's rich black people here, rich white people, it's real, everybody's cool and can.
So if a white person say nigga, they racist. Is that racist? Are they racist?
I'm not saying they're racist, but
that
word
comes
out their mouth. Right,
so if you say cracker, are you racist?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I ain't supposed to be calling them cracker. Why not? Because I know what I mean. If I call them a crack, I know what I mean.
Oh, you know that's just you saying. Okay.
So what do you mean when you call a white person cracker?
What if I said nigga?
What do you mean when you call him? Answer that for me. When you call him,
it's okay
for
you to say nigga.
What do you mean by all honky? What do you mean by
it's not racist?
If I say, hey, that's what I'm
talking about. That's like,
you mean
right on. I don't know him.
So you're right, he's probably on that show.
But like, that's just like,
when I was
young,
like, the new white people, they were. Why they didn't call me a nigga without for in a general statement, if you would say cracker, it's still easy to say.
What do you mean in a general statement?
Oh, I was talking to you. If I say, oh, I look at you, you probably say, you're not racist.
No, if I'm calling somebody
racist.
That, yeah.
But I don't see how it's okay for me to call him a nigga if he doesn't feel comfortable with that term.
It's not. If he's not comfortable with it, then if somebody told me, if I say, hey, yo, what up, my nigga, and you told me I'm not comfortable with you calling me a nigga, I'm not going to call you a nigga no more. Just like if, and it's vice versa. If somebody was to, if I was to go up to a white person to eat, and we just I'd be like, hey, what up, my cracker? If they tell me don't call me a cracker, I'm not going to call them a cracker. So it's a matter of respect. It's not just because you black you can say nigga, or just because I'm black I can call anybody a nigga. If they're not comfortable with the word, then I'm not going to do it because that's disrespectful.
Yeah, and at the same time, 9 times out of 10, you ain't gonna see a black person walking to a white person and say, what's up, a crack.
Yeah,
we don't do that.
White people don't go around calling each other crackers either.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the difference between the two words. Like,
and that's why we've, like, owned this word. Like, even with the word ghetto, like, it's like, it comes from, like, the Jewish, like,
yeah,
housing. Like, they don't even use that, but we done stole their word. Mm-hmm. Hey, you've been in the ghetto, like, you don't even know the meaning of the ghetto. Yeah,
I mean, that's acceptable
for them to say it. So we did.
Yeah, we made it.
Taking offense to it, I think it's hypocrisy.
I understand,
You can't steal some shit from somebody who used that to oppress you,
and then
use it on each other,
say, yeah,
and then when they use it,
you'd be mad.
I'm
going
to just.
That's how it works. I mean, it's not right, but that's how it works.
Yeah. I'm not gonna say I'm not ready to fight every white person who says
that. But just know you don't get that look like that. We ain't never that cool.
I'm very vocal, and I'm going to check whoever felt comfortable enough to say it to me. Because if they said it to my dad, he's not gonna check you the same way.
Right.
If they said it to one of my cousins, they're not gonna check you. This is me looking out for you. Hey, bro, that's not cool.
Because I don't want
that's
you to become
cool.
Comfortable and say it's me, where you go out in the
room
and somebody else.
If you say it to me around them, like, if you get comfortable enough to say that to me, and I do it in the dark, and then we in the light, and you say that again, yo.
How do you learn this? By somebody telling you or by you doing it? So if like with kids, I can tell my son not to do something, and I guarantee he'll do it.
Yeah.
And when it hurts, he won't do it.
Yeah.
You tell them, hey, don't say the word nigga. I'm telling you, this is gonna happen. And that ain't gonna happen. When they get busted in the mouth, I guarantee they won't say nigga again.
Yeah, but at least I can say I told you something.
Yeah.
But do you okay, so you're doing it for self-satisfaction, like,
I told you so. No, and even the, cause
that's
like,
what that
cause is. Because busting mouth might be me the next time. Because I gave you that warning.
Okay.
I'm not comfortable with it.
But I'm saying, if you...
So I gave them a warning.
Yes,
so the next time, you're gonna get a repercussion to it.
Okay, but I'm saying, like, you don't have to teach everyone.
Yeah.
Like, if I tell you that it's this, and you go out and do it, it's not like, oh, I told you so. A lot of people live for, I told you so, and hey, I was right. Mm-hmm. Hey, some people have to make that mistake on their own.
But at the same time, though, if you call me a nigga,
I'm
going to let you know,
yeah,
look, don't do that. I can't promise you what... But,
yeah, okay,
but
that,
but to me,
just said, but he's saying, like,
no,
black people don't want you to call him a nigga.
Right.
Yeah,
no,
right.
I'm saying don't say it around me.
Okay,
yeah.
What if it was a black girl who wrote crack on the board? You think we would know about it?
No, we wouldn't.
It would
know.
So, what role do you think the media plays in this?
So, the media will boost it up. That's a hot topic right now.
You think it's a reason for it?
It just kind of plays in the
probably to take our attention off something that's more important. I'm telling you, it's stuff that's going on that's way more important than that girl writing nigga and us writing cracker.
Yeah.
And then it's we don't know, but they're taking your eyes off of it.
I honestly feel they do that. They will pull up a fluff. Throw a smoke screen.
Ebola was in there for like, what, 2 weeks?
Yeah, but they had to distract us
from
something that was really happening.
That was really happening. Like,
and everybody scared to cough around each other for
and
2 seconds, and then, Ebola's just gone.
Yeah, and I think right now these small racist things that are happening are trying to distract us from the big things, because now you don't see anybody still marching for Mike Brown. You don't see any protests and stuff to one. It's almost like it's temporary thing.
But the thing, just because it's not being portrayed does not mean it's still happening. There are still marches right now for Mike Brown. There are still marches in Atlanta for Anthony.
Those little things are taking the place of the big thing that
taking the mass from it.
Yeah.
They're taking, like, the mass we were all focused on you know, the Ferguson situation and all of that. So when they threw that smoke screen up, there's still some loyal people down there in Ferguson who's probably still standing on the corner right now. But the mass, they distracted the rest of us.
I don't necessarily see it as a smoke screen. I see it as like, this is another incident that just happened that's related to this one. You know what I mean?
It's still, are you talking about the shooting? This shooting?
I'm talking the shooting, I'm talking about the nigger, I'm talking about the SAE. Like, it's still all related. You know what I'm saying? It's not the same situation, but it's still related.
It's still race.
Exactly. Factor. It's right.
Yeah,
so it's like, they didn't take the attention off of this. They're just like, yeah, this is happening. It's similar. Let's move to this now. It's not, it didn't take their attention off anything. It just said, this is the same thing that's happening over here.
I'm about to say some off the wall shit. Y'all feel free to disagree. But I've always felt that a white person who is not racist, not prejudiced against black people, that's an extraordinary white person. Because if you want to look at subliminal messages, if you want to look at even obvious messages, everything around us, from the news to media to everything else, tells us that black people are bad. So for a white person to look beyond that, I think that's exceptional, personally.
You buy anybody with a question.
Yeah, I'm not saying, but I feel like that's not, that's, I feel like you can't find anybody without prejudice. Because no matter, you might find people who aren't racist, but I feel like in everybody, there's a little bit of prejudice. Because if you ask a lot of white people, if you ask them, what is one food that black people eat? Fried chicken is the first thing they're going to say. That's prejudice, because you're boxing everybody into one category. So I honestly feel like there's nobody in this world that doesn't have a small bit of prejudice in them. Now, they might not act on that prejudice and discriminate, but there's nobody in this world that isn't prejudiced, because I'm prejudiced.
Okay, when does prejudice become racism?
When you act on it. Like,
it's the action.
There's a like, the definition of racism entails a person, or empowered above another race.
Yeah, they said
so
that they're,
you have to have, like, say for instance, you have a boss that chooses not to hire black people. That's racist.
Yeah.
Now prejudice is a white person seeing a group of black people and choosing to walk on the other side of the street.
Yeah.
That's prejudice. Okay.
What if that boss is also black?
It's still racist.
Is he racist?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's still racist. Take away the color, it's the act.
It's the act,
like you said. When you act on it, it doesn't have anything to do with the color. Black, white, blue, green. He didn't choose to hire those black people because of whatever the stereotype and prejudice is. So that's racist, even if he's
a
white.
I'm going to throw that walking on across the street racist, too.
I'll do that, too. I'm not going to front.
Black people are racist person. Towards black people in general, I mean,
is that considered racist?
I don't think the mass doesn't consider it racist.
You're smart. You know the race. You know the experience.
I'm not about to walk through a game.
But we call white people who do that racist.
I just said it's smart.
I would call that prejudice. Like, and that's a justifiable prejudice. Yeah. This history would show that doesn't always go well.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So if it was five black guys with glasses and suspenders and all look like Urkel walking across the street, the white person still, would you cross the street then?
Like, that's a perception that everybody knows that. Hey, you got a hoodie on, you're black in a white neighborhood. Like, it's just an accepted thing that. But if he had on a bow tie and a Bible in his hand with some suspenders, he probably would have got. So don't put yourself in that situation. Like, that's the conversation that my parents had with me. Like, don't put yourself. It doesn't matter if you want to accept it, but that's real. That stuff is real. So I'm not about to wear baggy pants in a white neighborhood with a hoodie and
look suspicious.
Look suspicious.
And the thing is, it ain't fair.
It's not
you
fair.
You have to admit that it's not fair.
You
got to accept it's not fair. We don't have a long leash.
Yeah.
We don't have it. So we have to do what we have to do to survive.
So
it's not fair, but we have to abide by it.
Exactly. It's not
fair. I agree that we shorten our leash because most of the ones with hoods on have walked around and robbed people and have done a certain act, you know, to give the world, not just white people, black people, they give us a certain perspective.
I'm not going to do nothing. That's what we shoot first, ask questions later. Hey, you be like, hey, I saved somebody, or like you said, I told you so. to prevent it from happening.
Thanks, Ace.
Like,
I was telling him thanks.
Have y'all ever heard that hate comes from fear?
Yeah.
Maybe you just can't be anemic.
It's not fair for you.
Ever since I wore my hoodie, I've been doing this before the whole trip.
But I mean, you got pink shoes on. I'm really not afraid.
You walking out, man. I mean, a little skeptical,
especially because I'm dark.
I got lost. Matter of fact, I got lost one time. I was going to get pizza, and I got lost, and I ended up like in the wrong neighborhood. It was dark. My phone was there and all that, and so some dude, like, I didn't even know I was in the neighborhood. But some dude yelled, "You better get out of here! I'm gonna call the cops." I was walking. We didn't have nothing in my hand. Didn't have a hoodie on or nothing. I'm asking him. So.
But I think, like, people in general, black, white, or whatever, like, this day and age, you have to have a hard shell. Like, I'm about to be a teacher. And they're like, well, you're going to get a job anyway because you're black. Like, me being black has nothing to do with me wanting to teach. Like, that's my desire to teach. Like, I know that I'm going to be an efficient teacher, whether I'm black or white. Right. So, them saying, hey, you're going to get a job if you're black. Okay, we'll give you a job if you're black.
But they will hire us.
She can take it how many times she wants to, and through that summer, it's a 5-week course.
They feed you everything.
This is
free.
Teach for Mary.
That's what she did teach for Mary. You write an essay. They pay you.
And then when you get there, if you get to a Title I school, that's another $20,000.
Exactly.
Your loan.
Like, so when I teach at Brewer in the fall, I won't pay a student loan. I think it's 125 payments I have to make at the minimum. $25, 125 payments, okay, whatever. And the rest is forgiven.
And so, it's not like you say Tyler Woodward, you automatically think it's like a terrible school. Brewer is not a bad school.
Exactly. Or Westview. I'm at Westview with Sam's kids. I don't have to do anything. The most challenging thing is to get them to, it's coming up for stuff for them, like, because they're smarter than me, like, honestly. So I got to challenge them even more. That's the biggest challenge I have. They know way more than we ever will. Like, this generation, like, that came after us, like.
There's so much potential in them. You just got to get them motivated. They
that's
their issue.
They're like, they say we're the laziest, but we're the smartest, though.
They're not motivated. As soon as we can find a way to get them motivated, dog, they will blow everything that the past generations ever did out the water. It was just, it's ridiculous.
It's about education and shit.
this is your major now. It's not integration.
Do y'all get offended like when you see comedians do blackface? Like comedians put on black makeup?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they're about to do something stereotypical that I feel like it's in the back of their mind. That's something they would think.
Is that racist?
Yes.
They're
just letting it manifest, but they're manifesting it in a way that so not many people would take it as being racist.
Like physical humor.
Yeah.
Like I was telling you about those Vine videos and everything, and I was like, I still take them as racist. Funny? Have a laugh at them? Yeah, that's my ignorance, but I still find them still racist where they put, like, we all seen the Vine videos where they're cutting up and call it watermelon, and it's like five black guys chasing a white girl with watermelon and a bucket of KFC chicken.
Alright, so was white chicks racist with the black people putting
I think black people are belittling themselves.
That was who?
And I mean, they didn't came up off of it, but.
Of course!
Still,
Is Dave Chappelle racist?
Huh?
Is Dave Chappelle racist?
No, I believe he's like an awareness. Like, he makes people.
I honestly
feel like, because I've listened to, like, interviews, and I can tell his, and the reason why he left the show, he said why he left his show. He didn't go crazy, he didn't get on crack, he didn't fly to Africa to run from everything. He said what they were trying to make him do, it wasn't being taken. It wasn't being taken the way that he was trying to. He was trying to make people aware of what we're doing to ourselves.
He's saying, like, his jokes always come back to, like, look at me.
That was his point. And when he said they threw $50 million at him to do another season, but they took his creative control. So now they'll be setting up the punts. Two white guys will be setting up the punts for his jokes, and now they're making these.
Yeah.
They're not trying to say the same thing he was trying to say. No, I don't feel he was
racist. That kind of goes back to what the man showed me the other day, how Hollywood, the masses.
Every famous black male has had a dress on. Has had to have a wig.
And he didn't want to be there, right?
He didn't want to do it.
Oh,
yeah. Wesley Snipes has done, you got
Chris Rock, Eddie Murphy.
Y'all think that's they're doing that on purpose? Like,
yeah.
What on purpose? Putting black men in dresses.
To
do what?
To
take one of, like, the I heard that too. Like, is it a concerted effort they're making, or is it just coincidence?
I don't know if it's it could just be that's what sells.
Would y'all wear dresses?
No.
50 million, no dress.
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody knows everything has everything is for sale.
That's what you eat. It's money.
You won't. But at some people, and I don't know if it's just you. Like you said, if they put 50 million, probably will fill up all of this.
Yeah.
So if they say this is yours. Put a dress on for a scene.
Would you put a dress on?
Dave Chappelle said
yes.
They walked away from it.
You got to live away from
that.
I understand that's my kid. I think what he's trying to say is like the whole selling your dignity and shit.
Yeah.
But for me, putting on a dress isn't selling my dignity.
I know.
It'll be something different that I'll say no. It doesn't matter what kind of money. But even in freaking Greek theater and shit, the original people who were playing women were men.
Yeah.
They didn't take offense to that shit. It's all about your perception.
Now, if they say have sex with a man, no.
Yeah.
A dresser.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying.
You just put on a dress and just be there in a dress.
That's
different than putting on a dress and strutting around like a little female. I'm not doing that.
It's accurate.
That's what the role is. Wait, no. I'm not saying that.
Like, I'm not saying you're wrong for doing it. I just know for myself.
That's, yeah,
that's not what I'm saying. I'm not doing
it. What about Amelia?
See, look, everybody here.
Against that, then that's one thing I can respect that. Mm-hmm. But if he's just doing it because he feels like, you know, they're trying to mm-hmm. come for him, and it's just his own insecurity.
Yeah.
It's just like niggas getting offended when somebody calls me, call me gay all you want. I like pussy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like that's wrong.
Because Landy was the guy. People call me that because I have gay friends. I had a gay roommate at Clemson. He got all the girls. Like
you.
Exactly. It's my roommate. Like, call me what you want. Yeah, like, I don't care. I know
I'm not there,
so.
I had to get
you.
Are
y'all
gonna say anything? Let's talk about these police.
Hey,
do y'all think police are racist?
Hey, the thing with it's a video clip, it's on YouTube. The white police officer pulled a white man over. He went to his car, the guy got out the car. He told him, get back. The police officer walked back to his car. The guy pulled out a rifle and started shooting at the police officer. The police officer did not draw his gun at all. The guy is shooting him through the window. All he's doing is, help. But they pulled a gun out on us like, hey, he. Like, we on the ground, handcuffed, and the gun is to your head, like.
Like, this is a touchy subject for me because my father was a police officer.
Mm-hmm.
I've met
my dad's police
officer. Many, many officers, mm-hmm. white and black.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not going to be foolish enough to say that all.
Oh, no, not all. You know, that's like saying all are corrupt.
Right,
yeah.
Right. I'm not going to be stupid enough to say that. I will, however, say this is a stressful job. That is one of the most stressful jobs.
And that's why I said, too, we had the conversation in one of our meetings, like, when you look at the time that those police officers have been like in service, it's like 3 to 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
So they're still rookies, basically.
Yeah.
And your life is on the line
right.
every day.
Right.
So it's either me or you. If he put his gun out on me and I got my gun
right
here, I ain't gonna talk to him.
Right.
Not at all.
And in that same respect, if you know how stressful and dangerous the job is, and you still go for it,
yeah.
You are held to everything.
Like, exactly.
If you mess up, that's on you.
Uh-huh.
No one made you be a police officer.
Right.
So, I lost my track of my train of thought.
I feel like everybody's not qualified.
Right.
And you have to be able to see the difference between a black kid with a hoodie who just has a hoodie on, and then a black kid with a hoodie who's out here trying to cause you bodily harm.
Mm-hmm.
And you can't just, you do not have a gray area. I mean, you have to be able to analyze instantly. Everybody's not fit for that. I'm not fit for it.
I think that they need, like, because I don't know what the police academy does or whatever, but, like, you really need those psychology classes to understand the human, whatever race they are, like. But then again, my life is at home line. It's a split second between deciding if I'm going to shoot him or I'm going to take him.
But going back to what I said earlier about people who aren't prejudiced against black people being, you know, being almost exceptional, don't you feel like today, black people to police officers are seen as disposable? Because every 187, who most likely is involved in that?
Black people. Yeah.
Every robbery, black people. So doesn't it make sense, as fucked up as it may be, doesn't it make sense that as a police officer, especially a white police officer, who's already innately scared of black people, when they see a black man, they see criminal.
Nope.
They see disposable.
One thing I think that we as blacks should do, know your rights and know your laws. Like, the police came to our house one time because he said it was a noise complaint. We had some computer speakers on there. They, like, my dad, retired Army, does police work. So it's like, I know what I can do and what I can't do. So the guy, he was like, well, could you get on in the house? I was like, how you doing? Gave him my ID and stuff. He was like, sit down right there. I was like, okay. He was just talking to us. And he just grabbed my arm and said, I'm gonna take you to jail. I haven't said anything. I was just like this. And I pulled away from him. And the other police officer was like, no, don't, you know what I'm saying? Don't do that, because I wasn't resisting anything. I'm sitting there on my phone just listening to him talk. But I know, I'm like, hey, I know, hey, you have a right to come here, but you can't come in my house. If you see something in there, they can come in. Like, if they were seeing bottles through a weed, that's probable cause. Yeah. But they didn't see anything. It was dark in there, and we had a curtain on. So it's nothing you can see. When I slid out the door, they left. That was it. I'm not going to use my rights as a citizen. Don't use yours as a police officer. I know you can't take me to jail. I haven't done anything to sit around here, so don't grab me.
I feel into all police. I'm pretty you know, aware of the legality and what I can do and what I cannot do. I feel like if I voice that, then it's resisting arrest. I'm being a smart ass.
Oh,
get on the ground.
I do. I let them know. Hey, I know.
If they do that,
they try.
And I've seen white people, what the fuck, what the fuck are you pulling me over for? They can say whatever, and they're like, oh, sir, you know you were speeding, boom, boom, boom. If I said that, it would be a different story.
But it's what you say, though. Like, I'm not going to cuss you out.
No, I'm saying, I could say it, like you probably said. You probably said it, like, I know
all the time.
I was like, well, I know you, I mean, you can walk around the house if you want to. You're not coming in.
We'd be looked at differently, even if we said it politely and whatever. And actually said the truth. Like, we actually knew the law and said what they could or could not do. If it was a black person telling them what they could not do, I feel like they're going to snatch me up.
But my thing
take
is,
me downtown. And then find me innocent afterwards.
Right. But just like we talked about, we have a stereotype. That's a stereotype towards all police officers.
That was
not all police officers.
True. He was very,
I've met
nice white cops who, and I wasn't wrong in a lot of those respects. And they, you know, I'm not classifying them all, but I'm saying predominantly, he would have locked me up, boom, 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 or at least put me in handcuffs, and I would have been guilty until found innocent. And if he pulled over a white guy in the same sin, the same everything that was going on, it would be like a different story. I just feel like he would not judge them as hard or be as harsh with them, you know.
I mean, I see what you mean. I understand, like I said earlier, that's a reality that we have to go through.
Yeah, and it's real.
Like, in our case, we have to go out of our way to prove that, like, yo, I'm not going to hurt you. I'm just being a person right now.
Yeah,
that's what he did.
It's funny that you said that, because my mom used to tell the stories of how my dad used to do that while he was driving. Because my uncles have been pulled over. A cop stopped my uncle and told him he didn't stop at the stop sign. My uncle stopped at the stop sign because he saw the cop behind him. Then he was like, well, you did stop, but your music was up too loud. My uncle wasn't listening to music at the time.
So
that's why they say but. Yeah. And they gonna keep making up.
Yeah.
Stuff.
So
but there's something. It's funny you say that because my dad has been doing that since me and my sister been little. Like, anytime we will all be in a car together and he would see a cop, he would automatically roll down his window and put his hand out the window and speak to the cop, like wave at the cop, so the cop would know he's a family man, he's in the car with his two kids and his wife. So the cop wouldn't think that there was anything going on.
Yeah,
he really had to go out of his way to make sure the cop didn't think anything of him, especially because the type of car we had at the time, and then we might have had tinted windows.
But a lot of times, like, when African Americans are put over, they're aggressive, like,
right.
You broke the law.
Be
that's your, that's their job to serve and protect. Like, if you run the red light, that's against the law. Like, you can break rules, fine. Yeah, break a rule. You can't break those laws. That's their job. So, if you go 1 mile over the speed limit, and the speed limit is 40, and
it's, 42?
And it's a, like, here, it's different from Atlanta. Like, Atlanta, you can go, like, 5 and 10
right,
over.
Right.
Here, it's a no whatever. So, you can't go 41, technically, but you're not going to stop at 41. Like, if you go 40, and if you go 49 and 40,
right,
they're going to pull you over here. You're going to get some points off. Yeah. Atlanta, they're not going to really
stop. They got bigger stuff.
Yeah, they got bigger fish to fry, but
you got to look at where you're at, too. Because, like I said, police in a small town, this is how they make the money.
Exactly. That's it. Yeah.
Big places in Atlanta, they got drug busts to worry about.
Exactly.
They got all type of stuff to worry about.
A lot
about
of stuff.
Traffic stuff. More not.
Every time I ran into a cop, it was, I felt like I was racially, racially profiled. And one time I went to jail, the dude said, let me see your license. I said, I don't have a license, I have a permit. And he took me into jail because I was being a smart ass. Went to jail for that. Then, when we went to, the dude, they had me living with a meth head, and so, this dude would literally do drugs all day, not go to class, blah, blah, blah. So this dude decided to come in, and it was like 3 o'clock at night. He decided to cook noodles, minus the water. So he puts noodles on the stove, and I'm going to sleep. So my sweet mate came in and woke us up, and we just seen black smoke all around the house. Me, my sweet mate, and my roommate is black. Well, Clayton. Clayton was my roommate, so I don't know if the cops knew what he was. We went downstairs, and when the cops came, we were just waiting on the cops. And the dude who was burning the noodles, he was trying to run away. I was like, yo, y'all don't see that? And so they wasn't saying nothing to him. So they was like, they asked me and Clayton, they was like, we gonna ask you one time, and we want you to tell you the truth. How long you been smoking marijuana? I was like, bro, I never smoked a day in my life. And then he was like, all right, well, we go ask you one more time. And he just kept asking me until I said yes. So I was like, I don't smoke marijuana. He was like, okay. So he went and got the breathalyzer test. Only tested me. I just woke up out of sleep. He didn't do nothing to the dude who didn't
look
like he was
high.
Huh?
Could you look like he was high?
Yeah. Oh, then he said, I look like I was high. Like, he did just wake me up at 3 o'clock in the morning. And my eyes are red. And he was like, there's a thing called a stigma in your eyes. So I know you've been smoking weed. So then I told my parents blah, 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 the next day. I was like, I'm the only one who got breathalyzed, nobody else did. And so he was like, well, go talk to the cop he did to you. So I went, and the other cop was protecting the other cop. I was like, can I go speak to such and such? He was like, no, whatever you got to say to him, you can say to me. So long story short, I was like, well, long as none of this stuff is on my record, I'm cool. And he was like, well, we did write you down. He said you did have some type of intake of alcohol, which is why the house almost went down. I was like, this nigga went upstairs and saw, my bad, we talking about this area. This dude went upstairs and checked and seen a little pot, like, coming from steam, and they came, and then I can't think. They thought I did, basically. So, I was like, how does that happen? Like, how can I not feel like I was racially profiled if I'm the only one who took a breathalyzer and I was the only one who looked high, blah, blah, blah.
But it was two other black people, though.
One was in a car, so they didn't. I don't even think they knew he was with us, because after he got out, he went in the car.
So were you the only black person?
Yeah, it was me, Clayton, and then the white people.
I told you, they're not scared of light skin dudes. They just
Clayton don't count as light skin. Clayton is almost white.
Yeah.
Are you white or like you mixed?
No, I'm Hispanic.
So okay.
What's your take on this, actually?
Yeah, because y'all haven't said anything.
Yeah, like. Family, your brothers, anything, like, do they experience, or do they feel where we're coming from?
Where what?
Where we're coming from, the whole, is that racist? Are they as sensitive, you know?
I see it more than my parents do. my dad has been more exposed to racism than my mom. My mom's more like, I don't want to say oblivious to racism, but she doesn't see it as easily as me, my sister, and my dad do. I have had experiences in the past, but I mean,
like what? I'm curious from like a girl, cause yeah.
I mean, I've had racist roommates in my freshman year.
What did they say?
They would throw like little racial slurs, like I should probably go to Taco Bell, we'll find a date or something.
Oh.
You want me to come up?
But I don't know, you mentioned therapy at work going to Taco Bell.
I'm Puerto Rican, but I mean.
Or Puerto Rico is it? So I would have been like, okay, that's stupid. Like, but some like,
my thing is she doesn't even really look Hispanic.
Yeah.
Like I would say you're either white or mixed.
Yeah,
or
exactly.
Like,
that's why I was
asking. I get a lot of people say that I'm mixed. I'm not. I mean, I am, but I'm not white or black.
What are you mixed with?
Like, I'm Spanish, like from Spain and Puerto Rico.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So
it's kind of like black. It was a boat stop.
No,
she said Puerto. I'm talking about Puerto Rican.
I think black people are creating their own racism too. They need to take stuff too far.
Yeah, take it too seriously.
Yeah, like they take a lot of stuff too far. Right. Like, I mean, I understand we're supposed to be proud of our race, but it's like now that we have like social media and stuff, it's like people try to throw being black in other people's face, and it's not that serious. Like, it's a difference between pride and being too boastful. Yeah. So I mean, I understand. I mean, I like being black. I don't know what any other experience would be like, but it's like people be making up little hashtags like Melanin Monday. Like nobody care how light black you are. I don't care.
Yeah.
What? You see
like,
that?
Melanin Monday.
Yeah.
They have their own little week for melanin. What color your skin is?
This is
melanin.
People the term melanin is like now.
So it's,
and what is that?
Everybody has melanin. Every black person has melanin, which makes you darker or lighter.
Yeah.
So it's basically like something that white people can't celebrate.
And that's the money. Okay.
Yeah. So then when they were talking about that show Black Girls Rock, he was like, well, if they had white girls rock, y'all would be. Somebody said that they had white girls rock, y'all would be upset.
Yeah.
And everybody was like, oh, you're scum for
saying
that.
I don't agree with that because I saw that there was like the first lady basically said that white girls don't rock. They're not worth it. Da da da. Because she went to Black Girls Rock. My take on Black Girls Rock is because how we're portrayed in media. So it's telling little girls coming up, a lot of whom have low self-esteem because they don't feel pretty enough, they don't feel good enough because of how media portrays what beauty is. They're not what people say beauty is.
But that's that's upbringing in home.
Yeah, but to say Black Girls Rock is racist, I don't agree with it because it's merely trying to.
Why not say girls rock and then have black women there to show that black women are just
but
as girl
one.
Or woman?
It's
on BET.
But I'm saying I feel like saying black girls rock is just a step down.
No, but it's BET.
Yeah,
you're celebrating you specifically.
But you're a girl before you're a black girl.
But that's the thing. It's hard to be a black girl than it is to just be a girl. I got two things against me. I'm black and I'm a female. You have things against you being black.
Okay.
That's the only thing a black male has against him is him being black. Me, I have to go through being a female and being black.
Definitely.
So to say black girls rock is lifting me up. It's not to put anybody else down, but it's to lift my confidence.
It's important for the opposition to realize just because we're building something up, don't mean we're tearing something down in the process.
I'm trying to say we need them to see black women as women, not black women.
Yeah.
Say something is black or it's a black talk show or it's a black movie. It's just that step down as far as society is concerned. So saying women rock is saying that, you know, you're not just a black girl, you're a woman.
That goes in
that's classifying.
Like that's that same word.
That's like on BET. If it was on anything else, it might be called that, but it's BET.
But
But like the whole thing is to uplift, well, talk about black people.
And like that goes like in that same argument when people say Black Lives Matter and you have some people say All Lives Matter. Yes, all lives matter, but at the moment we are discussing Black lives.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Your lives don't matter. Also, we're just saying, can y'all please realize and can we realize that our lives matter?
That's like going to a cancer run and someone yelling, yo, diabetes matter too.
Would you be offended at a WCU, historically white college? I'm saying like when you go to a if it was a college that was almost exclusively white people,
bro, that's what this is.
But most colleges are predominantly or historically white colleges.
Right.
Well, USC, I'm saying in the sense
where 7% black.
Yeah, but I'm saying in the sense where they're out with it, like this is for white people.
HBCUs aren't only for black people.
I've never heard of it. People said the name of the college.
Yeah, that's what it is.
And historically, two different.
But this is historically white. We didn't come in until the 70s.
But you don't call it historically white
college. It's implied.
See, that's an implied.
We have to do it because this. We have to let them know it's an HBCU. Because
why can't we just say it's
because it was black. Listen where it came from. We didn't have the opportunity to go to these big schools, so we made our own.
That is our history.
I agree with that.
So that's how they're trying to keep in our history.
So you're saying, what if they call this a historically white?
No.
Okay.
It is, but it's just the wording.
It's the wording.
No, I'm aware of wording.
Like that's what it is. Like I'm well aware. This is a historically white college. We didn't show up to the 70s here. And that's okay.
And I want to say even women weren't allowed here.
Yeah, exactly.
But it was still all white girls.
Exactly.
You know, like, that's what it is. Like, we all
know. And I'm not offended about that. That's just what it is.
Okay, what about a white entertainment network?
That don't even sound right. What?
That's like...
BET
did change the whole abbreviation. It's not Black Entertainment Television. It's bringing everyone together now. So the whole thing about
the reason BET is okay is because. Like it goes back to what I was saying. We didn't have this. We have it now. This is a for us by us type of thing.
Yeah, but they changed. You better bring everybody in, or y'all ain't gonna be here at all.
Even though BET still let other races be in it, like Jen was a rap battler who won BET. Yeah. Then when they did the top rappers, you know who's number one? Eminem. They don't hate on white people. They celebrate their heritage.
Yeah, it was just.
Have y'all watched the BET Awards?
Yeah.
Do you feel that your view is different because you didn't directly come from the same line we did?
Yes.
I mean, that's just everybody's upbringing, but it doesn't make ours the exception. This is off the topic, but like with the Adrian Peterson thing, like when he beat his child, like I was ready, I got beat when I was little. I don't whoop my kids. Like my son's been mean to his. So I just told him go in there and lay down and think about it. Come back and talk to me and apologize to her. And that's what he did. He was fine. He doesn't be mean to her anymore.
I have a lot of people.
I don't. But that didn't do anything. That didn't do anything for me. Like I did it again.
Yeah.
And I kept doing it. Like. But when my mom started taking, like she was like, "You can't go to that basketball game." She took my game away. She took my posters away. That shit hurt me because that woman is temporary. When he saw her playing with the iPad and he couldn't for the rest of the day, that boy didn't say nothing.
But like you said, every kid is different too, so it may work for some. But the thing with Adrian Peterson is he took it to another level.
Yeah.
Like everybody's been beat before, but he took it to a whole other level. Nothing was okay.
You got whoopers?
Yeah.
You had marks?
Yeah.
I was in school.
Like that though.
Hey.
Because he's African and he's not. I'm saying that was my point of asking.
Okay.
Because even to him, we're not the same. And Uzi would say the same thing too. He's not raised like us.
Right.
And me, actually, I'm Bajan. None of my heritage has came from, I'm from Barbados. None of them have came through a slave trade or anything like that. They came straight from Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So they're not in the same category as an average black person.
Right.
But I still allow myself to see the race because the white person doesn't care if you're African or African American.
Yeah.
They're going to see a black person.
Exactly. But that's the thing, and I acknowledge KKK career, they killed all of us.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing about it that I guess gives me a different perspective.
Headquarters
is
happening
now.
The
thing that gives me a different perspective is the fact that, you know, we talk about racism, we talk about
what we are. Like, if I say, yo, you know Alan, which one? Yo, dark skin Alan.
Yeah.
Like, there's probably eight different Alans here.
That's
like,
a description.
Right, yeah. I'm talking about middle school, high school, like,
yeah, but some people who really don't. It's some people who don't
like
your color.
Yeah.
I guess, like, we're just Americans, though.
But that way, he said middle school, like, you don't think, like, the middle schoolers don't
think
they're maturing
right now.
I understand that, but most of the people we see here, they're still scarred over shit that happened in middle school, right, in high school.
And that's something that they have to do.
That's something they have to do, but most of society is like that. A lot of people we see walk around here dead inside because of some shit that happened in middle school, high school, based on being black, being cracked on about your head, being cracked on about your skin, bleaching your skin, different shit like that. But who does that to you? Black people.
Yeah.
But we want to, because like the way I think about it, I was like, if I was white and I see these police shootings and shit like that, I wouldn't care. The reason I would,
you, because when it doesn't directly affect you, people don't really care.
That
like,
too,
honestly.
That, but the way I think about it would be, they kill themselves more than cops do.
Yes.
They hurt themselves more than cops do, and I have to give a fuck.
But look, but if I kill you, I'm not. I didn't swear an oath to protect
right.
and
yes.
to serve and protect you.
Mm-hmm.
So when that police officer has the 2 seconds to kill you, like, when I get pulled over, I'm like, oh shit, maybe, you know what I'm saying, let me tell the officer that I have a concealed weapons license. Let me tell them that a gun is in there.
Right.
Like, you have to tell them that. Even when I took that class, the police officer was like, it don't matter if you black or white. If you don't tell them that they, like, and you reach in there, oh, the gun dropped out. Their instinct, he has a gun that he's reaching for, he didn't tell me. He's not thinking, well, maybe he forgot about it.
And,
no.
And see, I agree with that completely, but the angle I'm coming from is the resources, the time, the energy, we used to protest and march and fucking cuss people out on social media about this kind of shit. If we use that to actually change the psyche of black people, educate our kids better,
but
would we be in the future?
But do you not think that people are trying to do that?
That already happened.
They are trying to do that, but where's the bulk of our energy going? Protesting. It's kind of like protest.
No, to me.
Sometimes.
For what?
The last one I went to was the march on the Capitol about the rebel flag flying.
Yeah.
You know?
Nah.
Which I feel some type of
thing. They still have the rebel flag.
They
still have the rebel flag. On the state building, they still have the rebel flag.
It's still on state house grounds.
Yeah, it's still on the grounds, but they took it from off the top of the building.
So, what about them saying that the kids can't wear American flag in the school?
You saw that too?
What about that?
When I protest about that.
Yeah.
Yes, would you say, hey, we can wear American flag?
Yeah.
I got a problem with that.
You can't wear it.
Yeah, that's because
If they wore it on Cinco de Mayo. So they said that because the kids wore wore apparel with the American flag on it, it was gonna cause racial tension. So they banned it. They banned apparel with American flag.
Right
in America.
Because no, but I'm saying Woodruff, the kid on the day, the kids wore the American flag and they sent them home.
They suspended them.
You know how they're country out there. They got the big trucks with the big flag. Right. And the girl in my class, she was like, they sent them home. Cause the
they wore the rebel flag?
No
they
American
wore the
flag.
American flag.
See,
that's
like schooling about learning no more.
Yeah.
Like you're being like I'm all for tolerance, but you're being
yeah, this is America.
You're punishing me. But that's the thing, who draws that line? Because what offends you? Because
that's common sense, man.
But it might not be. If I'm in America and I want to represent America, and I'm not allowed to do that in a, like,
yeah.
America,
yeah.
I'm
yeah.
But also
that's
I'm going to
get
out of America.
I'm in the
Army, this is,
and I can't be proud of being in the Army when I enlisted in the Army to fight for America, and you tell me I can't be proud of that shit?
But also,
that's
it goes
right
back
now.
To what he said, with that intent. They, like, the original kids that wore the flag on Cinco de Mayo, they might have did that with the intent of, like, oh, this
true.
Is Cinco de Mayo, but I'm still going to rep my
true.
Stuff.
Yeah.
To build the issue.
I hear that.
You know,
but,
and it messed up for everybody else.
But those children were young. I feel like they ain't nobody got that kind of problem.
I mean, either way, go out there
and
school.
But you
can
never
learning.
Know.
School
yeah.
School
yeah.
About
you never know. Because a white person could wear a rebel flag, and it could mean two different things. It could either mean they hate niggers or Southern pride. But
yes.
It's up to you to say, does this offend you?
But either way, go
out there and
school.
I got a rebel flag in the back.
You and Allen?
Hey, how you doing?
School should be about
you. Yo, with a dolphin, bro.
School should be about school. It shouldn't be about your wardrobe, blah, blah, blah. As a matter of fact, I never had to wear a uniform while I was in school. And in 12th grade, yeah, it was like, you know, people getting picked on, so everybody got to wear a uniform.
But I can say I've worn a uniform, like, people say, like, it's not what you wear.
It's
but when you put on, like when I dress up, like, if I put dress clothes on, people who wear, like, dress clothes, like, I
you
feel different
mm-hmm.
than when I got this on. Like,
you want different and shit.
Yeah.
You're like,
oh,
shit.
Like, yeah. And you're like, hey. So when I wore uniforms, I was like, well, I feel a little bit. I mean, I know I was smart, but I had all A's.
No, I'm saying.
But, like, when I wore that shit, I was like, hey, I'm smart.
But that might just be you. Either
yeah.
way, even though you got to wear a standard color and a collar shirt, everybody's not going to have the same exact brand. And everybody's been in school before. It's always a way to pick on somebody if you really want to pick on somebody.
Yeah.
Even if it comes down to
yeah.
their shoes not being
But
a
with the
coach.
With the uniform thing in Atlanta, I know the thing they did that because there's like a lot of gangs. So it's like
that's
neutral.
What we
you're wearing white and the khakis. Like, that's it. You tuck your shirt in. We know you don't have any guns under there. Because, like, literally at our high school, like, 3-4 shootings a semester. So, it's not. It's bigger than being picked on. This is life. This is life.
People wear whatever. When I moved to Newark, New Jersey, they did that.
That's
that
color
because
you still wear
that.
That's New York. They know about
you still
go to school, though. Like, they have, like, blue pants on and red pants.
Just like that in clubs.
I'm gonna agree with that though.
You can't wear hats in clubs. You know?
I'm gonna have to agree with that. But like I said, perception and whatever.
Right.
I have to agree with that because I've seen a person get shot for having a Raiders hat on, which represents Folk Nation.
Yeah.
And he was from like Ohio or something.
Yeah.
But he was in Boston, and that was a blood neighborhood.
Exactly.
And he had a Oakland Raider hat on.
And according to them, his intention
and
was
for
to
your,
the,
yeah,
and
his and for protection, we're not allowed to wear those hats.
Right.
Well, we're not allowed to wear flags. You can't fly them. Any type of
that's
flag.
Situation.
But okay, but it
always
happened to him. They never did it to another student.
That's why you gotta know where you at. Cause like how when I talk, I say cause. I'm not gonna get away saying that
yeah,
in a lot of different
that.
Places, but 9 times out of 10, I might sometimes say "cuz" at the end of a sentence. Like in Compton, I'm not gonna get away saying "Civil War is cuz."
But if you know,
you
if you know that stuff, put yourself in situations where you know it's not gonna.
But some people don't know.
Yeah, cause I don't know. Like, I didn't know "cuz" was disrespectful.
Like my son's
blood is bloody.
I got a Dodgers hat on.
The
nigga, the next car to me throws a CK to me. I'm like, I'm just wearing a hat because it matches my shoes.
Yeah. Like, you can say deuces is like a game term.
Really?
Listen,
I'm
off
the show.
Listen,
I'm off
the show.
I
don't get out of
my
like,
I'm not.
That might mean something.
That's
to somebody.
I have like family in gangs, and they explain like if people do this, like they don't take offense if I, you know what I'm saying, wear a certain color because they know I'm not in the game. But others, if they see you doing this, like and got like any guys around here, like they'll be saying like you don't do that. Like my brother will ride in the car. My son is in the back. He looking over like the guys are doing a they were doing a handshake. I picked my son up. They're doing a handshake. He rolls down my window, and asks them, "Hey, like, what set y'all playing?" Like, I'm like, it's way deeper than like.
Yeah, that's like a whole new knowledge.
And they got hard for it.
Matter of fact, I was saying that about
I don't even like they willing like. Is they battling over turf that don't belong? Yeah. No, nobody has to use that land. Yeah. That ain't your turf.
But I think it's a family thing.
But when you look at the deeper thing of it, they say like encryption.